guys, how y'all doing? I am Tamiko, the founder and the owner of HBK Vegan Way, which means Honey Buns Kitchen. So it's always been my dream to have my own restaurant. I love feeding for my friends, my family, the homeless, less fortunate people, stuff like that. I just get a great joy out of cooking. I'm a little nervous. But anyway, I just said I need to just stop being nervous and do it. I'm also going to start a new vegan baby food line called Jace Nature. It's my godson, and we're going to get together. So today, I'm going to make for my very first video. My niece called me and told me that she wanted a good black bean burger. So I thought I'd make one from scratch. So what I have is a half an onion chopped up. I'm going to put all this in the food processor. We have a half a red bell pepper. I don't like green bell pepper because it's not ripe. It's bitter. I like the flavor. I don't like tasting it. And we got a jalapeno. And we have a few chipotles and a half of orange pepper. We're also going to put breadcrumbs in it. She wanted to season, so we got seasoned breadcrumbs. I don't use a lot of salt. And a good way to salt your food without using a lot of salt, because I just recently found out being a vegan, I learned more about health. So being a vegan, I just found out that we're supposed to have no more than 5 grams of salt a day. I'm working on it, baby steps. I'm not a complete vegan yet, because I still eat a few snacks that I probably shouldn't eat, but I'm going through transformation. For the last 2 years, I've been going through transformation. But by the end of this year, I will be 100% plant-based, but mostly just about everything that I cook and that's in my household is vegan. Every now and then, somebody might give me like, oh, taste this cookie. I'm like, cookie. They're like, God damn it, it wasn't vegan. But whatever. So, the seasoning we're going to use today is garlic powder.
Minced garlic. Chili powder.
Chipotle. I might not use chipotle because I got the extra pepper. So we're going to put that to the side. They like it hot and spicy. We'll add that later on the top. And then we're going to have chili lime. We're also going to do Mrs. Dash. Like I told you, I don't use a lot of salt. I'm not going to do Himalaya salt today. I normally do that. We're going to lay off all the salt. Because a lot of this stuff might have salt in it. We're going to have cumin, smoked paprika. I absolutely love smoked paprika. We're also going to have a little vegan mayo in it. And Dijon mustard and pepper. I feel like I'm missing something. So we're going to put a little, I could never pronounce this word, so we're not going to do this on the first video.
So,
in this bowl, we had 2 cans of organic black beans. I rinsed everything off because a lot of food that's packed in cans and stuff, it has a lot of sodium in it. Hold on 1 second. Let me turn the temperature down.
I'm back. Anyway.
And a little olive oil. And I'm going to top it off with plant-based cheese, and it's a hot pepper cheese. We're going to use a pretzel bun. I'm not going to use no bun because I had chips today. That was enough. Okay. So we're going to put all this in the food processor. Again, I'm sorry. I have mushrooms, 2 cans of black beans, and corn in this. We're going to put all this in the food processor. Always put a little oil in your food processor. A lot of people might not do it. I do it all the time. For some reason, I'm very nervous. A lot of people do not know this about me, but I'm a little shy to people I don't know. And they don't think so because I'm so loud, I'm so vorturous, and I'm so crazy. But I am really shy. That's crazy, ain't it? But I am. But whatever. And I'm shy to y'all because y'all don't know me. Once y'all get to know me, we be family, you know?
Okay, let's do it. All right, we're going to
put this in here. So my nieces are here, and they didn't get in the video. I'm so mad because I really needed them here, but it's okay. They're here. But they'll reap the benefits if I die. Okay, so we gave that a couple pumps because I want the peppers and stuff to be kind of smushed. So we pumped them a little bit first. Then we're going to put the black peppers and stuff in there.
The corn, everything
is drained, everything is washed. I kind of prep stuff I cannot stand when you do YouTube videos and you watch them, and they gotta go looking for shit. I don't have the patience.
I'm a Virgo.
I'm very annoyed. I get very annoyed quick.
Okay. But anyway.
So why don't you guys tell me a little bit about yourself in the comments?
Girl.
Okay, let's get it. All right. Like I said earlier.
Alright.
I'm a little sweaty today. I went to work out. Shout out to my trainer, baby. He's gonna get this body right. Okay. We're gonna go to Jamaica. Like, hey, I'm here. Yes. I can't wait to go to Jamaica with my peeps. Okay. We're gonna cut a little more onion in this because I love onions. They might not. Let's go. Oh, I think my niece is coming through. You coming? You coming to visit?
I'm coming to say hi.
My niece is coming through. This is one of my, I'll call all my nieces favorite because all of them is favorite in my own way.
Hey, y'all, make sure y'all comment, like, subscribe on my TT Buns, HBK, the vegan way.
Y'all make sure y'all watch
her every day.
All right. I'm going to try to start on doing videos twice, three times a week, and then I'm going to start doing them daily. Okay. Let's get it. Am I cute? You don't look at that ass. Stop that. And I'm a very silly person, so I hope that I don't offend anybody. People that know me know I'm very comical. Life is too short to be mad at everything.
And if Corona taught us anything,
it taught us to live life.
And live in the moment.
So, I don't mean to offend anybody. I'm a very comical person. Say a shout out to Darius Cooks. I love you and I've been following you for a long time. Can't wait to meet you because I will meet you. I'm gonna put you on my video. My niece just looked at me. You're doing the most, but whatever. Can't wait to get your vegan cookbook too. Sometimes I gotta get off your page because I look at your page. I'm like, man, I think I want to smother pork chop dinner. I be wanting to go back to regular food.
Okay, so
once you mix everything up,
I'm gonna put everything in this bowl. Oh, wow.
I just said I don't like when people walk right from the camera. What the hell am I doing? It won't happen again, baby. I'm the type of person that once it happens,
okay.
So, did I smash this too much?
We'll find out. It don't matter.
My nieces love me. They're going to eat it anyway. And they're going to talk about me later. So, and a separate thing, but what do you want on these fries?
Seasoning on
them. You want seasoning?
Yeah, that's cool.
Okay. So my niece wanted fries. Both of my nieces want fries. I'm gonna put steak seasoning on the fries. I'm gonna put them in the oven. They already made. I won't be eating no fries. Then again, if they don't look, I might eat one or two. What time is it?
Okay.
So
we didn't put everything together.
I normally don't use measuring and stuff like that. We're not making our recipe.
We're doing everything to
I. I can cook.
We do measuring
later on in life. Right now, this is what we're doing. I'm not using a lot of salt. So remember, I told you season, I'm using black pepper, chili lime, cumin. I really don't like cumin, but my niece love it. So I'm going to use a little of that. Chili powder. Well, cumin and chili powder, a lot of people don't know, it's similar. Paprika, smoked paprika. I'm going to put a lot of that in because I like the taste of it. Keep it moving. Mix garlic. Put a tablespoon.
Okay, one or two. Did you say something?
Garlic is always good. We're going to take off the ring. This ring represents clarity. Last year I had to get my mind right. Okay.
Sure how many breadcrumbs to do, so let's start with a half a cup of breadcrumbs, and then I want y'all to see me wash my hands.
Please practice washing your hands, especially with the corona going on, okay?
I cannot stand when I see cooking shows, they never wash their hands, and they touch their face, for real. Then you tell them to taste it. Taste what? I'm straight. Okay, this is real mushy, so what we're going to do is add more breadcrumbs because the recipe calls for an egg.
Like I said earlier, we're vegan. I don't feel like making
a flake egg. Maybe I could make that, but let's try it without it. Put enough breadcrumbs in it.
Yeah, then it'll be, yeah, we don't need no egg. So what I'm going to do is
probably make this once a week until I perfect it because I wanted to make it greeny with like kale and stuff like that in there. So I'm going to make this again. Like I said, I love cooking.
So I'm going to taste a little of the
mixture so I know what the mixture needs.
It's not going to kill me as all beans. I think it's good. Put a little garlic powder in there. And I put a little chipotle because it's not
as spicy as I thought it was going to be.
Oh, this jalapeno. Okay, well, I'm going to put a little jalapeno. My nieces love it hot. It's so funny
that when I was heavier, I used to always have a sweet tooth. I still have it now, but now I don't eat like I used to. Now I have more of, I like stuff that's spicy. Like me.
You try it.
Excuse me. So we're going to put a little
Dijon mustard in it. The recipe called for it.
Did it say how much?
I'm just gonna do about high.
Well, you've been cooking as long as me. I will be 50 years old this year.
And I've literally been cooking for 41 years.
The first time I cooked something, I was 8 years old, and I cooked the whole dinner.
Okay. Vegan mayo. Okay. Nisi Poo, just turn the skillet on for me.
I sure can.
Thank you.
What do you want me to turn it on?
Probably turn it on me.
Hi guys. Y'all make sure y'all go subscribe to my YouTube. It's called Cooking.
I'll tell y'all in a minute.
Baby.
Pray for us all, baby.
Okay.
I'm adding a little more seasoning because it's not salty, but I just love flavor. So I'm adding more paprika. Once I perfect the recipe, then I'm going to put all the right amount of ingredients on there. Okay. Can you taste it? I'm going to put this on. So we're going to turn the big iron on. So I'm going to set up this right here so I can put the burgers.
Okay, set it for
me. I got it. Thank you. Okay. So, I am like truly OCD. I have shit everywhere. So let me just briefly clean this up. You know what I feel like I'm making? Meatloaf. Maybe I should make a black bean meatloaf one day. And smother in spelt flour gravy.
Look it up.
I will. And two to do it. Next week, I love spinach pie. I'm going to make a vegan spinach pie. I'm gonna do next week. While the stove cooks, I'm real quick, wipe everything down. A lot of people do this later. Like I said earlier, I don't like stuff everywhere. Okay. I'll finish cleaning this up later. So we're gonna make some of these guys a little bit something about myself. I used to weigh 384 pounds. I lost 180 pounds and then coronavirus hit for real. And I gained 30 back. I got in contact with a guy I used to work with, and he was always a pleasant guy, a gentleman, a good guy, and I watch him on Facebook all the time, and I said, you know what, I don't know why people are trying to, this is my trainer right here, And I've been working on him. And the first one is really just like a test. That's good. I really good. Anybody check the fries? Alrighty. We need that skillet to calm down a little bit. We don't want to burn the burger. I'm probably just gonna make two and do the rest later. As I'm looking at this, I feel like that I might poke everything together too much, but it's okay because it looks like real ground beef. Sometimes you see black bean burgers and they, next time I get on here, I'm gonna have music and everything. I just wanted y'all to get to know me. Okay. Let's get these look okay?
Mm-hmm. I believe in you, baby.
I know, of course you do. What about you, Nisi Bun? Did I suggest a tutor? This is a big skillet, but I'm gonna make sure I can lift it this way around it. I can't flip the
camera. Okay.
Okay, I just wanted y'all to see what those look like. Okay. So like I said earlier, I always wanted to have my own restaurant. So the plan now, and to get like a my version of a vegan tropical smoothie. And the reason why I say vegan because tropical smoothie, I mean, doing with fruit. Fruit is already vegan, but tropical smoothie, I'm not sure if they use sugar, but I know they use carbonara. I want to start using just like dates and maple syrup and agave and stuff like that. And I just want to get a vegan place where they sell vegan food. I can still do my dinners, and when I'm cooking for catering and cooking for less fortunate people and straight up hungry people, that I will have a platform to do it. All right. So we're gonna cook these a couple of minutes on each side. Small, come check these off. Okay, well, they're looking good. What I'm going to do is, can I pause the video? So what I'm going to do is pause the video, and then I get back on when I finish the fries and the bread and stuff and piece it together. One sec.